The famous Brandberg quartz from the Gebobosep. Now, I selected this piece because it has such lovely form. There's a very, very slight touch of color in this guy as well. You see there's a little bit of purple, maybe smoky amethyst. Predominantly clear though. These little flakes you see inside the quartz, some may call it harlequin quartz. In this case, it's not very intense. That would be little flakes of hematite included. Some may say lepidochrosite included, but these do actually show off red, which will tell you it would be the hematite inclusion. Have a look there. Very, very difficult to photograph. I think the still pictures don't do it much justice. Even the video is difficult, but in hand it's a bright, lustrous little guy. Look at all those little vugs, and that gives the fire of the Brandberg to these quartzes. Let's go around like that. Lemurian writings, tiny yet very present on the sides of these crystals. Little crystal adjoining, or is it? There's a little diamond face on this side. It's going there, or is it a diamond face? No, it's actually two crystals which have adjoined each other there. So I'm going to now focus on the reflections to give you an idea of the crystal form. Lovely little guy. And I think on the matrix of course being in this case maybe some chalcedony, which is also a variety of quartz, but typically these guys sit on a basalt lava, and there may be tiny calcites on that section over there, all the way from Namibia, Brandberg quartz.